Hi everyone. So in this video, we'll try to fix the error which we got in the previous video, which was about running the DB sync. So that error was just about the path SRC app modules. It was spelling mistake we were having here. Now if we just try to Docker compose up, first we will try to get our containers up. Now next thing is we can attach a shell and npm run dbsync. Okay, so what it will do is it will try to create the entities for us, and now after that we will create more entities, like we will try to have some kind of a relationship there between user and post, and we will see how that works when we run the dbsync. And later we will just create the migrations. Here you can see it has created the table name user. Okay, and in the migration we don't have anything, so it won't do anything. So what we will do is we'll try to have a relationship one to many between user and post, and we will create entities here. So this is my user entity. So what I will try to do is I will try to have one to many relationship with the post. So post is another entity which I will be creating. One to many I have, and with one to many, this is my callback, and how my user is associated with the post is this post is the entity which I will be creating, and based on the post I will be able to fetch the user. So here you can see the user, I mean one to many means single user, one user can have many posts. Public posts we have, and it will be the array of posts. Let me just quickly check it if this is correct. So we have created a post of post array. Okay, now we just need to take care of creating the entity post.ts, and it will be another entity which will be managing the post user blog post I'm talking about here. So this post entity will have may have a relationship with the comments. Okay, I will just here putting it, and we are not dealing with comments for now. So class validator, what comments? So we have a user entity. I'll just try to fix it. Okay, we just need to fix the entities. Because it is just asking us to initialize the data, we can just use the exclamation with the type. It will just say okay, yeah, we will initialize them later. And this user entity export class, so we have to import using named export. Few things, let's fix quickly. So we are getting user, and here this user has no initializer. Let's put exclamation. Yeah, so we are trying to fetch the posts based on the user. So eager fetch means whenever you are trying to fetch the user, then you will be able to fetch the post related to that user. And similarly we have to make an update here, import posts from, have we imported correctly? Yes. And here we have, post.user, let me just check. Yeah, now this is kind of complete. So now we have, what we have done is we have defined a relationship between the user and post. Oh, it is still showing an error. Number declaring implicit has an any. Just see. Okay. Yeah, this is fine. I'm just adding semicolon unnecessary. Okay. So it has a now user has a posts column which will be managing all the posts associated with that user, and it has a one to many relationship. I will just play around it and we'll try to run it if we are able to get the data. Now I can run the npm run dbsync again. What it will do is it will try to just see the entities. We have a user entity and a post entity, and both has a entity annotations, all the column annotations are there. So it will try to create the relationship, and it will create these tables in the database, because we have already defined in the ORM config.ts that look at these two tables, look at these entities which are inside this particular folder. So it will see what all entities we have defined. One is the user and one is the this test, and you can see the foreign key relationship has been created. So same thing I think we should be able to see here. You can see the posts and user, and moreover if you try to just create a relationship out of it, okay, that we can do later. I'm just trying to see, show you the relationship again. I think we are getting some warning. Test is the database, so let's show filter. Okay, excluded object to be processed. So I have these three tables to be processed. I have included everything. Execute three tables from schema test. Oh, sorry, it was in the bottom. I was not able to see, and I was thinking this page is empty. Sorry for that. So here you can see the user and post, right? So you can define the, here we have a defined relationship, and whenever there is any migration created, right, that migration will go into the migration table. Because when we do npm run migrate, so all the new migration will get inserted here. That will just a migration name and the primary key. So that whenever you run npm run migrate, npm run migrate, then it will not create new tables and add additional column, because migrations are need to be created once and should be executed only once. Okay, so this is required utility. Now what we will do is similarly we'll create other tables. And we will create a simple database with the three or four entities, and we will define the relationship between them, one many to many, one to one. And then we will create a controller and services to insert, update, delete the data from them.